Hi, this is Brian with Ikan, and today I'm going to be showing you how to set up an Ikan teleprompter monitor and an Ikan talent monitor. So this is a full teleprompter setup, which includes the talent monitor and the main monitor. So this monitor right here is going to be running the teleprompter script, and this one is going to be a live feed of the talent, so that way they can see themselves on the screen. I'm going to go ahead and turn around this setup so you can see the back of the monitor. So this is the back of the teleprompter monitor. So here we have four main inputs. We have our 12 volt and 24 volt input. We have our HDMI video input. We have our VGA input. And then we have our AV SD input. So we have two different variations of the teleprompter monitors. So this one right here is just the regular version. On our SDI version, it's gonna have a 3G SDI input here. All right, so let's go ahead and plug in our monitor. This is a threaded connector right here, so once it's plugged in, it's not gonna come out. So we're gonna go ahead and plug it in and then secure it with the thread, and then it should be turned on. All right, so now we got the monitor plugged in, we're gonna go ahead and turn it on. All right, it's gonna load up with the splash screen here. So now let's go ahead and look at what the buttons do. So these three buttons right here are your main input buttons. So if you're gonna be running HDMI into the monitor, you'll just click the HDMI button. VGA, you'll push the VGA button, and then AV, you'll be pushing the AV button. Since we're using the HDMI port in this video, we'll go ahead and push that button. So this flip button right here will allow you to flip the video either horizontally, vertically, or both horizontally and vertically. So you have to set that in the menu, but we'll get to that later. And this right here is just your up and down arrows, and then we have our main menu button here. All right, so let's go ahead and open up the main menu by pushing the menu button. All right, so let's go ahead and go through these menus and I'll explain what they do. So we'll go into the main video config menu by pushing the menu button. A lot of this is pretty self-explanatory. The contrast, if you push the menu button here, then it'll turn pink. And then you can adjust the contrast. You can increase it by pushing the up button, and then you can decrease it by pushing the down button. Brightness, it's the same thing. You can just push the menu button, go up and down to adjust the intensity of the brightness. So you can adjust your backlight settings, you can adjust your tint settings, chroma, sharpness. You can adjust the intensity of the red, green, and blue pixels. And that's all the settings from the video config menu. Next, we'll go to the system config menu. So this right here is the menu duration. This is going to allow you to change the amount of time that the menu stays up before it goes away. The video ratio is something that you would want to change. If you have a 16:9 video feed, if you want to have the aspect ratio appear correctly, then you'll go ahead and change that to 16:9. So in order to do that, we're going to go ahead and go to the video ratio. We'll put that to 16:9, and then that'll set the video signal to 16:9. Since we're going to be using a 4:3 signal, we'll go ahead and set it to 4:3. Next is our flip horizontal. So if you want to flip the video horizontally, you would just push the menu button. You can go to on, and then if you want to flip it vertically, you can put that to on, so you can see it flip vertically. And then so if I hit the flip button again, it'll just flip vertically and horizontally, since both of them are set to on. If I turn one of them off and then hit the flip button, it only flips horizontally. So in this case, we're gonna go ahead and set the flip horizontal to off, and then go ahead and exit out with the menu button, and then we're gonna go ahead and return. The PC settings are locked, so we won't be going into those settings. Okay, and we'll go ahead and exit. So this monitor is a 4:3 aspect ratio monitor, and the native resolution is 1280 by 1024. So next I'm gonna show you how to set up the Prompter Pro 4 scripting software and run it at the native resolution. So now I'm gonna go ahead and plug in the other end of the HDMI into the monitor. All right, so now you can see that our monitor, it looks good, but the aspect ratio is stretched. So in order for us to get the correct aspect ratio and to get everything pixel to pixel, I'm gonna show you how to go ahead and set that up. So first you wanna go to your main computer and you wanna go to the Windows button and then just type in display. And then you'll see the display settings menu come up and just hit enter. So you want to make sure that your displays are set to, under the multiple display settings, you want to make sure that it says extend these displays. Don't make sure that none of the other options are selected. So click extend these displays. You also want to make sure that make this my main display is checked, and then make sure that monitor number one is selected. So that's going to be your main monitor. So your main laptop monitor is going to be your main monitor, and the secondary monitor will be the teleprompter monitor. So next we're going to go to advanced display settings, and then we're going to go to display 2, and this is going to be our teleprompter monitor. Right here you can see it says desktop resolution 1920 by 1080 and then active signal resolution 1920 by 1080. So we want to get both of these resolutions to the native resolution of the teleprompter monitor, which is 1280 by 1024. So just go ahead and go to display adapter properties for display 2. So this is our secondary monitor. So we're going to go ahead and click list all modes, and then we're going to go scroll down to 1280 by 1024. And then we're going to do the 60 hertz version. So we're going to go ahead and double click that, and then we're going to hit apply. And then you should see that the monitor is now displaying correctly. So go ahead and click keep changes, click OK, and you'll see that it's displaying correctly. Now you want to click display 1, display adapter properties for display 1, click list all modes, and then you're going to go ahead and go to 1280 by 1024. So this will be also the main native resolution of the monitor. You want to make sure that this is displayed in 4x3. You know, if you don't run it in 4x3, it's going to cause some problems with the scripting software. So just go ahead and click OK, and then click Apply, and then you'll see that the display is now in 4x3, which is what you want. Click OK, and then you'll see that your desktop is set to the correct aspect ratio on your main teleprompter monitor. So now we'll go ahead and open Prompter Pro. All right, we'll go ahead and open it up. Now that we have Prompter Pro up, we'll go ahead and full screen it here. And then we're going to go to Open Talent Window. Go ahead and click that, and it's going to open up a new window. So what you want to do here is go ahead and drag this window across to your main teleprompter window. Go ahead and bring it up to the very top to full screen it, and then come back over here to this monitor, and then click Talent Window Full Screen. And then you're ready to start adjusting your font size and your line height. And once you have everything set exactly how you want it, you can go ahead and start prompting by clicking the Start Prompting button. And then now the teleprompting script is pixel to pixel in the correct aspect ratio. If you want to speed up the script, you can push down on the keyboard. If you want to slow it down, you can push up on the keyboard. If you want to rewind it just a little bit, you can push the R button, and that'll rewind it a little bit. And then to keep it going, you'll just scroll down by pushing the down button. And then if you want to stop prompting and then change any of the settings, you can go ahead and push the stop prompting button here, and then adjust the font size, and then you can go ahead and start prompting again, and that'll just resume where it left off. And now I'm going to go ahead and show you how to set up the talent monitor. So the talent monitor is pretty much exactly the same as the main monitor, except that it comes with an adapter that allows you to connect it to the 15 millimeter rods. So once it's already set up, we're going to go ahead and get the power cable, plug it in, and then screw it just to secure the cable. And then once it's turned on, you'll see a blue screen here, and then it's going to be followed by the Ikan logo. So what we're going to do now is plug in the camera directly into the monitors. Okay, so I have an HDMI cable for my camera, and I'm going to go ahead and plug it into the monitor. All right, as you can see, we have a picture of our anchor here to represent the distortion and the aspect ratio. So you can kind of see it looks a little bit long and it's also upside down. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is go to our menu, and the menu is gonna be upside down. So you're just gonna have to look at it differently. Go to the system config, push menu. We're gonna go to the flip V. We're gonna push menu, and then we're gonna go ahead and set it to on, and then push menu one more time, and then push the flip button. Now it's set to the correct orientation. Also notice that our shot is flipped horizontally too. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to the flip H. I'm gonna go ahead and set that to on as well. And I'm gonna hit menu, and then I'm gonna push the flip button, and then I'm gonna push it one more time. And then now it's set to the correct orientation. So now I'm gonna go to the return button. I'm gonna go to exit. All right, so now that we have the image in the correct orientation, I noticed that it still looks a little bit stretched. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna change the aspect ratio to 16:9. So to do that, we're gonna go ahead and push the menu button. We're gonna scroll to system config, push menu again, and then we're gonna go down to video ratio, push the menu button, push the arrow, and then it looks like auto automatically set it to 16:9, but I wanna be sure that it's 16:9, so I'm gonna go ahead and set it to 16:9, and then I'm gonna push menu again. And then I'm gonna go to return, go to exit, and then there you go. Now we have the image set to the correct orientation and the image is no longer distorted. So now we have a full setup of our teleprompting software running. We have our script running. We have our talent monitor set up correctly with our anchor. So now I'm gonna show you how to set up the main teleprompter monitor with scripting software running on a Mac. So first you wanna make sure that your HDMI cable is plugged into the back of the monitor, and we're gonna plug in the other side of the HDMI cable into the Mac. And then, so what you wanna do first is go ahead and click the Apple logo on the top left corner, and then go to System Preferences. Click Displays, and then you'll see that you'll get two windows that show up. One is called BSD HD, and the other one is called iMac. So the BSD HD window represents the teleprompter monitor, and the iMac window represents the iMac monitor. So what we wanna do first is go ahead and go to Arrangement on the BSD HD window. And then if you have mirrored displays checked, go ahead and uncheck that. And then what that's gonna do is separate both windows to where they're in their own space. So next we're gonna go ahead and go to display under the iMac window. And then we're gonna go to scaled and make sure that that's checked. And then we're going to click the 2048 by 1152 resolution. And what that's gonna do is whenever we go back to the arrangement tab, you'll see that both of these blue rectangles are the exact same size. If they're not the exact same size, just go back to the display setting and see which resolution will get both of these rectangles the exact same size. All right, so once you've set your resolution, you can go ahead and exit out of this window, and then we'll go ahead and hit Command Space and type in Prompter Pro 4. Since we already have it installed, we can just run the software right away. All right, so once you get Prompter Pro 4 up and running, the first thing you're gonna wanna do is click Open Talent Window. So what this is gonna do is open a new window with only the teleprompter script. So once you have this window, go ahead and move it around and move it to your teleprompter window. So once you see it in your teleprompter window, go ahead and unclick it, and then come back to your main window on your iMac. Go to the top left section of the screen and you'll see a button called Talent Window Full Screen. Go ahead and click that, and then you'll see that it'll put that window in full screen. So that way it's just the teleprompter script. And then from here, we can go ahead and adjust the font size to our liking. So if we adjust it here, we'll just hit the slider and adjust it. I think that's a pretty good size for about 25 feet. You can also adjust the line size, but we'll just go ahead and keep that to the default setting. All right, so once you get your font size and your line height set, go ahead and go up to the top and you can go ahead and start prompting. So just go ahead and click the Start Prompting button at the very top left of the window, and then you'll see that the scroll is moving. So from here, you can go ahead and click down on your keyboard to speed up the text. You can push the up button on your keyboard to stop it or slow it down. You can also use your scroll on your mouse to adjust the speed. If you scroll down, it'll also speed up the text. So another feature of Prompter Pro 4 is a rewind button. So if you're scrolling through your text and you're going too fast or too slow and you want to rewind, just push the R button and that'll rewind it a little bit so you can kind of readjust. You can also do it when it's fully stopped as well. So that's how you set up the Teleprompter software on your Teleprompter monitor. So for more information, go to ikancorp.com. See you next time.